What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? What's going on? It's Keyshawn Scott. What's up? Listen, I just ate some peanuts. So if you see anything in my teeth, let me know. Because I don't want to be looking bad on camera. All right? What's going on? So I have a special guest today. Her name is Kate. And she's from Heart of the Dayton Conference, which is going down in February. So what we're doing is that we're going to bring Kate on. She's going to talk about the conference. We're going to talk about, you know, Dayton, you know, all those gushy, nice things that we like to talk about. And if you have any questions, you guys can ask questions, brief questions, you know, because where I'm at, we late. Where Kate at, it's early. So she's in an amazing place. Let's see, where is she? Let me see. But how's everybody doing? How's everybody? Happy New Year. How's everybody doing? Thank you so much. Happy New Year. Where's, oh, there you go. Let me back this up a little bit.
Oh, is my service? You're
on. What's going on? I kind of switched.
Hey, Keyshawn. Okay, no worries.
What's up? How are you? No. I mean, we just spoke. I'm like, how are you? The same I did 5 minutes ago?
I'm good. I'm doing what just like I was a few minutes ago, but good. My dog is being more interactive now. Yes, I have a dog. We learned that on the previous live. Are you
like definitely
that?
We definitely did. We
You're definitely like, hey, there's something in your house. It's a
there's something. Run. Get out now. I'm gonna call the door plus. You know, that's great. I'm so happy that you're on now. You know, the other way around, I get to ask you the questions.
Let's go. It was so good. If you guys missed it, we talked all about breakups and all the things on my page, which, you know, Keyshawn is the expert on this. He's so great. But hey, guys, I'm so excited to be on tonight.
Yeah, thank you so much. So let the audience, let people know, you know, who you are, you know, what do you do, all the nice stuff.
Yes. Hey, guys. So if you don't know me, I'm Kate Warman, and I run The Heart of Dating. 4 years ago, The Heart of Dating started as a podcast. We still have the podcast, but since then it's grown into so much more. So Heart of Dating is the overall umbrella for the podcast. I'm now a best-selling author, which is actually a book on rejection, ironically, that came out almost a year ago. I have a dating program called Drop the Hanky, and we do annual conferences. And so, speaking of conference, we have our next conference coming up this February, and I'm so excited because Keyshawn, you are going to be speaking in the conference on an incredible topic. I already had a sneak peek, and it's so good. I'm so excited about this conference. Basically, it's all I'm doing day and night, night and day, from now until February 12th, like getting all the things ready and together for this conference, which, by the way, if you guys are curious, it is a Christian dating conference, okay? Yeah. So, which really doesn't exist out there. There's really not any Christian dating conferences. And you can either join in virtually, so from anywhere in the world, like no matter where you're tuning in, or you can choose to come live. We do have tickets and people coming in Orlando, Florida, which is going to be a rad, amazing time. Really community building. We're going to do a lot of fun activities together. You're going to get to meet other singles, both men, if you're a single woman, and just other awesome friends. You know, if you're that person who is divorced, or you're a single parent, or if you just feel like you're the only one and there's no singles around you, I'm so excited because the conference is going to unite so many single Christians in one place. And I just have a vision of seeing not only romantic relationships come out of this, but just even friendship connection, you know, speaking of things like going through singleness and breakups, like we need strong friendship connections to help us through those seasons. So if you feel like you don't have any of those, you're going to find some people at the conference. So that's my spiel. That's what I do. And I'm so happy to be here.
And I tell people that all the time, right? I tell people that it's not about only romantic relationships, but it's about the relationship with friends and family. Yeah. And, you know, the ones that we meet along our crazy journey in life, because you'll meet people who will really be there for you and love you.
Yeah, it's so important. I mean, those are the people that have gotten me through so many seasons. Like, and they're the people that in my heart is heartbreak. They're the people that I can text and call. And they jump on a Zoom call, and this actually happened. It's a real story. my close friends that I've cultivated for years jumped on a Zoom call. They were located across the country, across the world. Somehow, some of them have kids. It just aligned. God allowed it to align where we were all available at one time, and they were able to jump on a phone and pray over me and be there for me in the moments after a really hard heartbreak. And that's beautiful. It's those moments are so healing. We need to have strong community. So
So I wanted to know, like, what got you to the point to create this conference? Like, did it pop up in a dream? Like, what was it?
starting out 2020, I was like, I had a vision of a conference that was an all-day conference where we had sessions, powerful, we would break things down, it'd be really powerful content, and then it would end in like a mixer where singles would get to meet each other and it would be fun and cool and not like weird Christian singles events. And so I had that vision, and then 3 months into the year, as we all know, COVID hit and that changed, obviously. So I couldn't do an in-person conference like that. But 2 months after that, so in May of 2020, I was like, oh gosh, like now more than ever, singles need community and encouragement. Like, I really wish I could do that conference. And I was invited to speak in a virtual conference, and it got me thinking, oh my gosh, like, what if we do a virtual version of what I wanted to do? And then eventually, one day, we'll do the in person and all the fun stuff there. So that's where it began, and we did. I threw it together, Keyshawn. My first conference, it was thrown together. We had over 30 speakers, and we threw it together in a month, 4 weeks. Okay, and we had 5,000 people come to our first conference, and it showed me, like, man, community is needed. Like, the content was awesome and powerful, but above and beyond that, it was about the community and people meeting people and just making sure they didn't feel alone, especially when we were in the height of COVID. So, but now we're in a place where we, can kind of do more things. I mean, a lot going on with the whole COVID thing. But anyway, so I'm so excited that we actually get to do some of that vision, which is have the in-person portion as well.
I love it because vision is so important, right? Because even in the word, it says, write the vision and make it plain. And you were so obedient to the vision that you created this, what you probably was in your mind. And you say, you know what, Kate, you got this crazy idea. Let's just do it anyway. And then you did it, and it became so powerful, and it's changing lives, and people are making so much great connections with it. And like we mentioned before, it's not only romantic relationships, but you can build relationship with genuine, real people who believe in God, who's chasing after God, who is ready to pray for you, who's ready to love on you without expecting anything in return. Now, everybody's not perfect now. I'm saved Christian and I ain't perfect, right? I had my share of talking behind people back sometimes, but we have to understand that we need people in our life that's going to help us get to that next level. But let's talk about dating now.
Yes, let's do
It,
it.
it's beautiful. So the last conference you did, right? And I know I didn't even throw no questions at you. I didn't, send you an email and say, hey, this question. I just be going with
I'm down for
it.
anything.
But did you have any success stories?
Yes, I actually, we do have quite a few success stories, and we're putting it together in a video, hopefully, to launch at this
Ooh, nice.
upcoming conference. But yeah, I had people that through the content of the conference actually started dating in a new way. And then right after that, they put themselves out there in a new way or did things differently, and then actually met someone who they're now engaged to. I got an email like that not too long ago, and I was like, oh my gosh. But not only is it about the romantic connections, but the biggest testimonials we've been seeing from the conference, outside of profound healing and profound and amazing connections, is people like actually have found their best friends through the conference. Like, truly, they're lifelong, this is my person. And I wouldn't have met this person if I didn't come to this conference and see them on the Zoom and connect with them. And whether they live across the country or even in the same state, there's people who have made like long distance friendships. And I saw so many people this last summer, actually, when COVID, we were in like a better place. People were traveling across the country to meet people they had met at conference virtually. And it was so cool. We got all these people sending in photos of, here's my meetup. We met each other at conference. I was like, oh my gosh. So that makes me so excited because a lot of my audience is people in that feel like they're the only single person left. you know, that everyone else is getting booed up. They're in their 30s or even later, and they're like, why am I the only one here? I go to church, nobody else is single, like, or they're 20 and single, and then they don't look like me, you know? And so I love that it's been able to connect people in that way as well. And so to see like photos of people meeting up this summer and feeling so seen and just supported was like, I mean, that's worth it to me entirely. Not to mention like the engagement or other romantic connections we've seen come from it too.
And I love really good stories because people feel as if this, like, I have to go and meet someone who's single. The person you're meant to be, you never know. They're probably in a relationship right now, about to get out of the relationship in a year, and then they're going to heal. And then for some crazy reason, you guys will meet up somewhere. You don't know where, right? And the reason why I say that is because my wife and I were both engaged at the same time to different people, but she knew of my relationship and I knew of hers because her ex used to live like a couple blocks, like a block around the corner from me, and I see them all the time. I see them like, hey, what's going on? How you guys doing? All right, say hi to both of them because they're in a relationship. And then as years went past, I got, my fiance, it wasn't working, and then she, her relationship didn't work either. So then years passed, and then she invited me to church. She said, hey, come with me. And I said, no, you're a creep. I'm not coming to nowhere. Don't invite me to church. Let's go out to eat. So she kept on asking me and asking me. Then one night I said, you know what? Whatever. Let me just go before. So I went, and I was just
Fine, I'll
sitting
come to
there.
church with you.
And I was sitting, and she came next to me and everything. And then her ex was actually behind me, and I was like, okay, I thought you were in a relationship. She's like, no, I'm not in a relationship. I was like, wow, you're not. And that kind of forged our relationship, in church at that time. So I say that to tell people that you don't know what God has for you. What God has for you might be in a whole different situation. Don't use my story and think that you're gonna get together with a married man or married woman or somebody who's engaged. But you don't know what God has for you or where He has it for you.
That's so
So
true.
it could be virtually, it could be in person, but you have to have discernment. I want to talk about your book though. Tell me about your book.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's called Thank You for Rejecting Me. And it really, the book is broken down into so many different ways. Every chapter is a different form of rejection. And oftentimes with rejection, we think of just like heartbreak, especially when we're talking about dating. And I do talk about heartbreak in the book. But there's so many different kinds of rejection. We could feel rejection from friends in a work environment. We could self-reject. The book actually starts with different ways we self-reject. You know, we reject ourselves before others even have a chance to. And so this book is really 12 different ways in which we have to face some of the deepest, most powerful, and hardest rejections of our lives. And a lot of people have said it's like a therapy on wheels. So every chapter is like one subject. So I even talk about abuse. It's one chapter. I talk about cheating and healing and rebuilding trust, like that kind of thing. Every chapter is a different form of what could look like a rejection in a sense. And then at the end, you reflect, you do reflection questions, you write a letter to either yourself or to that person or to that thing that you're trying to break free of. And so every chapter, you could almost do every chapter in its own silo with whenever it is applicable to your life. Or you could obviously read the whole thing through as well. But it came out last February 16th, and which is so wild to me that it's almost been an entire year since it came out.
Anniversary
So
is coming up.
Oh my gosh, that's so wild. It's right. The anniversary is like right after my conference too. That's the first time I even thought of that.
That's beautiful, man. That's really good. So, what geared you to write the book? Is it something personally that happened? Is it something that you've learned?
I love that. So
You
yeah, it
can
really is
tell
a
me,
lot of,
Keisha, I don't want to answer that, but I
oh
know it's
no,
for you
no.
to say, I don't want to
Hey,
answer that
hey.
question.
No, it's out there. I mean, the whole book is out there, which is filled with these stories. And so it, I wrote it because it's really my journey and my story. And before I wrote, let's say, a book on how to date well, what I felt so strongly about is like, before we do that, we need to talk through your relationship with yourself, your relationship with God, your relationship with rejection, how much pressure you're putting on dating. And that's so much of my story. And really working through how I see myself, how I self-reject, reworking through my own, the image of myself, learning to be the woman that God has created me to be. working through my fears of rejection and working through a lot of the traumas that led to things like what, which led to a lot of healing, but traumas like abuse that I've been through, traumas of cheating that I've been through, traumas of bullying back way back in the day of high school. But those things all impacted how I was showing up today in my life for myself and in relationships. And so the whole book is basically filled with my own personal stories of rejection and how God has helped me heal those things, albeit not perfectly, but I impart a lot of different tools that help me heal through all those varying kinds of rejection. So it's so fun. Thanks for asking that.
I love that, you know. And one thing I'm getting from this is God didn't forget about you. You know, for those who's listening right now, I want us to know that God hasn't forgotten about you. He hasn't forgot about your story. He's going to make your mess your message. He's going to make your pain your purpose. Because if it wasn't for Kate obeying God and going through her process or her season, you know, and kind of acknowledging what you've been through, you know, saying, you know what, I acknowledge you. You know, I'm aware that I'm going through this. If it wasn't for you doing that, we wouldn't have a conference. We wouldn't have a book. You wouldn't be here right now. You know, I would have never
It's
known
so
you.
true.
So it's so important to follow your purpose and kind of grow through what you go through. And that's what you did. You grow through what you went through. And
Yes, and that's,
and that's the amazing part.
and you
And I think that's
said,
what we have to understand.
you said it too, the transform pain into purpose. That's part of the subtitle of my book, Transform Pain into Purpose and Learn to Fight for Yourself. Because everything in this world is going to try to reject you. There's going to be so many things that are uncontrollable that we have to deal with every single day, from big rejections to little rejections to big hurts to little hurts. And we have to learn to fight for ourselves, fight for our own healing, fight for our own sense of value and love. Like, nobody can truly take that away from us. We have to fight to keep those things and to know that, like, where we get them is obviously from God as Christians. But this was, it's so powerful to know what you're saying. And obviously, a lot of people on here, I'm assuming, are single. But no matter what your story has looked like, even if you're not proud of your dating journey, whether it's very extensive, you've dated a lot of people, or whether it's filled with nothing, a whole lot of crickets, you've never dated anybody, and you're like, why am I 35 and single? How has this happened? No matter what it looks like, I want you to know that God is using every moment in your story. He's weaving it all together like a tapestry. I heard somebody say this recently. If you look at a tapestry from the front side, it's beautiful. It's colors and it's all weaved together. But on the back end, it looks chaotic. There's threads. You don't know what's going on. It looks weird. You can't see it. And so a lot of times, and when we're in our moments of processing, we're in the back end. God's weaving it all together. We haven't had a glimpse of what he's doing on the other side yet, but we can rest and be certain to know that he's going to transform and mend and meld all those things together and weave them together to create a beautiful tapestry that's unique and different and colorful. And so, and everybody's is different. That's the thing, is that every person's is different. It's unique. Nobody's tapestry needs to look like somebody else's. That's the beautiful part of how God has formed us. And so I believe he's done that in my life, and he's still doing that in my life. And I love to impart that same empowerment to singles to say, even if you feel like you're the only one and you hate where you're at right now, just if you could even have for a moment press into that tapestry picture we just talked about and just say, wow, I have no idea what kind of a masterpiece this is going to be one day. Like, I have no idea, but if I can keep focusing and clinging to hope every day by day, your life will be transformed if you're able to have that mindset and walk through it day by day like that.
That's so beautiful. I'm actually one last question, right?
Okay, do
What
it.
would you what would you say to to that Kate in the beginning of this transition? Like, what would be your advice, someone? Because there's someone out there who is in your shoe, right? Someone who is that Kate from a year ago, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 5 years ago. What would you tell that version of you today?
Man, and that specific, the lowest place I've ever been was almost 10 years ago now, which is so wild to think about. It's 10 years, but I would tell that girl that she's doing so much better than she thinks she is. One of my biggest issues is how hard I am on myself. And I would tell her, you are doing so much better than you think you are. You don't have to have it all figured out. Just take one step forward today. Just focus on one more step. That's it. One more step today. I just that like makes me almost want to be emotional because I think I see it not only from my past life, but I see so many people. We're so hard on ourselves. We are so hard on past versions of ourselves. We're so hard on ourselves because of our stories. We blame ourselves, we shame ourselves, and in the process, we're stuck and we're not able to find that true healing and that true freedom and that true purpose that God wants for us when we remain stuck. So I would just tell her that you're doing a lot better than you think you are, and that you're not alone. So, man, that was a good question, Keyshawn. I
That
love
was a good
that.
answer. Yeah, I loved it. And that's what Heart of Dayton is all about, you know. And I think that what I explored from this conversation and what I got from this conversation is that the person who created Heart of the Dating Conference is someone who is pure, you know, someone who is after God's heart, someone who is not selfish, you know, someone who doesn't want to just see people get married and, you know, live a life, but you want purity. That's what we want. We want purity. So, guys, I need you to get your tickets. You got to get your tickets. If you didn't get your tickets
You
yet,
gotta
I don't know
come
what's
out.
wrong with you. You got to get your tickets. Ask somebody for some for the cash to get it because it's not about just the money. It's about the investment. It's January. It's still the new year. We're what, 17, 16, 17, 18. I'll be forgetting about the days, but we're somewhat days in. Get to the conference. If you can't make it to Orlando, you can definitely get it online. We're going to be
Virtually.
online. We're going to
Yep.
be giving you information. You need to get at you need to be at that conference. If you're a Christian, if you're a single, if you're Christian or not, let me change that. If you're Christian or
Yes.
not, if you believe in God or not, this conference will still bless you, but you need to take the first step. We can't do it for you.
Yes.
All we can do is give you the information. All we can do is talk to you right now, but you need to go on my page or Kate's page, and you need to purchase your ticket to go to this. This could change your life. This can change
Yes.
your life. You got to get there.
Wow,
You have to
that's
go there.
powerful.
All right? You have to. So, you have any last thoughts for
No,
anyone
I'm
else?
so
Anything else that you want to
excited.
say?
This has been so fun. Keyshawn, what you do is so powerful. I'm grateful for you. I'm so thankful we got connected. And I'm excited to see so many of these people, hopefully, at the conference next month, virtually or in person, you guys. I'm
Absolutely.
really, it's going to be awesome. I mean, I know I'm a little biased. However, just I you ask somebody else who's been to the conference, join our Facebook group, be like, hey, I'm thinking of joining this conference. Can you guys tell me what the other ones have been like? Don't just take it from me. Ask people. They're gonna tell you how incredible these past conferences have been. It's the testimonials and the people have come. It speaks for itself. So we'd love to have you there. Take that first step for yourself.
Thank you so much, Kate, for your time. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your time is very valuable. You're very busy planning the conference,
Oh,
so thank you so much.
thanks,
I really
Keyshawn.
appreciate it. We'll definitely connect, and I'll definitely be at the conference, and I'll see you there.
All right, sounds good, my friend. Thanks for everything.
You're welcome anytime.
All
Take
right,
care.
guys.
Good night.